there, I'm Stephanie. I'm so glad you're here today because I'm going to be talking about something so near and dear to my heart, which is body image. If you're new to my channel, I talk about all things motherhood, being a new mom to a 3-month-old baby girl. I'd love for you to subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate your support. And give this video a thumbs up too if you enjoyed today. So I do want to ask you a question, and it's a question I've asked myself before, and it's, why am I pressuring myself to get back into my old size? This doesn't only apply to postpartum, but to many stages of life. Why am I pressuring myself to get into my high school jeans? Why am I pressuring myself to get into my dress pre-baby size? Where is the pressure coming from? And most likely, it's not other people that are pressuring you, but it's yourself at the end of the day. So why? Why do we do that? I really think a lot of it has to do with social media. A lot of it has to do with the way we're trained to think about postpartum. Like, oh, you're so cute with your little baby bump. And then all of a sudden, once you have the baby, nope, no one thinks you're cute anymore. Being a mom is a beautiful thing, and it changes your body. Not to say it's for the better or worse, but it does change. And I think the most important part is recognizing that and remembering why and rebuilding your mindset in order to help you to adjust to those changes. Today, I want to share with you some things that have helped me develop a more positive body image to help love my body after having baby. This first one, I actually think is so important that as soon as I tell you, I want you to pause the video and do it. That's how important I think what I'm about to tell you is. I really encourage you to ditch the scale. I know that my body image significantly increased once I got rid of having a scale in my house. Once I did it, I just started focusing, instead of how skinny I was, on my strength. Instead of being hyper aware of how many pounds I needed to lose, I switched my mindset to fueling my body with healthy food. And it helped me better be able to recognize my hunger cues and when I'm full. I'd highly encourage you to do the same in order to live out a healthier lifestyle. I also noticed a really significant impact in my body image when I got rid of full-length mirrors. I found that when we had full-length mirrors in the house, I just became obsessive with pretty much seeing what was in the mirror. Focusing what was on the mirror. And I was spending a lot of energy and time on that and perfecting that, if you will, rather than focusing on much more important things in life. I feel like it just made me feel worse about myself. It took away from relationships in my life. And now that you have a baby, you know, that is the most important relationship you want to develop right now. I think you'll feel so much better if you spend more time looking into your baby's eyes rather than focusing on what's in the mirror and loving yourself just the way you are. Also, developing more of an exercise routine, even if it's super light at first or you have to make modifications and take breaks. Getting into like a small workout routine after having baby, it's helped me feel really good about how strong my body is, as well as how capable I am of doing certain things. And that little bit of challenge I found has been really healthy for me. But getting some movement in throughout the week has really helped my mental health and given me a more positive outlook to be the best mom that I can be. Another way to love and honor your body is to eat healthy food and in moderation. I love the word moderation because it allows you to enjoy all your favorite foods in moderation. Life is way too short to constantly restrict yourself. And I find that if you cut something out of your diet cold turkey, it really, really just ends up backfiring. But being able to enjoy your favorite foods if you have a craving, like for McDonald's, or if you want a couple cookies after dinner, and you know, you allow yourself to do that, when you have a craving, I just find that you're able to balance things out better by having healthy meals throughout and giving into some of those niceties in life. I also want to encourage you to honor your new body. I talked about this in my other video, but it's like once you have a baby, you can't unbaby yourself. Like you can't go back. Or once you graduate school, you can't uneducate yourself. So change, it's not for the better or for the worse, but it is change. And learning how to adjust and adapt to your new self is super important and super healthy in doing so. So finding new clothes that help you feel good and confident, even if that means going up in size, it's so important to find new clothes that help you feel good and are comfortable, that fit. And I think that would be such a game changer for you into adjusting and loving your new body. I really appreciate you watching this video today. I'd love for you to subscribe to my channel for more motherhood videos. I'm all about building a mama community and I'm here for you. If you have any questions at all, please feel free to leave them down below. And don't forget that you're doing such an amazing job and that you're the best mom you could possibly be for your baby. Sending you guys lots of love. Bye.